Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adley A. Este, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, The Need for the Morning Watch. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Psalm chapter 34, verse 11. It says, Come, my children, listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. Children, yesterday morning story of the two little girls, schoolmates in our church school, still haunts me. Why did one of those juniors grow up and become a happy missionary, serving the Lord with her husband in the mission field, while the other girl ran away from home when 15 and at 21 was in a hospital awaiting death to erase the memory of her tragic mistakes? Why did one stay converted and become a wonderful witness for Christ, a loyal, faithful soldier of Jesus in the army of the Lord, while the other one chose to cherish sin in her life and finally died as a sacrifice on the altar of sinful pleasure? Obviously, one remembered and kept her Pathfinder pledge, while one did not. In our Pathfinder pledge, we say, I will keep the Pathfinder law, and keeping the morning watch is part of that law. Is it enough just to repeat the Pathfinder pledge and law at our camp meetings or summer camps or at other important meetings for youth? I personally believe the time has come in this degenerate age when every junior boy and girl should repeat the Pathfinder pledge and law every day of their life and keep them as long as they live. What happens to a person who neglects this spiritual ritual? They are in great danger. Here is a wonderful quotation from the writings of the Messenger of God that points this out. Genuine conversion is needed, not once in years, but daily. This conversion brings man into a new relation with God. All things, his natural patience and hereditary and cultivated tendencies to wrong, pass away, and he is renewed and sanctified. But this work must be continual. For as long as Satan exists, he will make an effort to carry on his work. He who strives to serve God will encounter a strong undercurrent of wrong. His heart needs to be barricaded by constant watchfulness and prayer, or else the embankment will give way, and like a millstream, the undercurrent of wrong will sweep away the safeguard. nor renewed heart can be kept in a condition of sweetness without the daily application of the salt of the word divine grace must be received daily. Of no man will stay converted. Our High Calling, page 215. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, before starting your activities today, have you started your day with your personal relationship with God? Hear His advice through His Word and surrender your life in His protection through prayer. Children, remember that Satan is trying hard to lead you into his trap. He is like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. Therefore, ask Jesus to always guide you in all your ways and surrender yourself in his protection so that you will avoid all the traps of Satan. Children, let's start your day with your time with God. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.